Hello, investors and traders, and welcome to the Weekly Market Report. I'm AJ Monti, and this is a one-year daily candle chart of the CBOE Market Volatility Index, ticker symbol VIX. I'm starting off with the VIX because we saw a very interesting candle show up today. And as I zoom in here, you'll see that last week, which was Friday right here, I drew this line to the downside saying that we would most likely test that support level and then bounce. And when I said bounce, I drew this extended forecast line out to March 24th with the high being closer to 41.42. Now I want to stay focused on this bounce right here because this is very important. First of all, it doesn't happen that perfectly all of the time where the pivot point that I draw on these zip lines are that perfect where the low for the day is right at the pivot. However, if you look down below, there's still a major support level down here on the VIX right around 17. I don't think we're going to go to that level anytime soon. However, if you look at the shadow above the candle today, what this tells us is that at one point during the day, this was an extremely long green candle, and it looked like the VIX was going to start to really run away. But the fact that the volatility pulled back towards the end of the day left us with this long shadow. Now, if you look back in the past, we do see long shadows at the tops, more or less at the pivot points or the inverted Vs. But I do not think we're going to go back to these lows down here. I think what's going to happen is I think we're just going to pull back just a little bit on Monday, maybe at the beginning of the day, and then get right back on track with higher lows and possibly higher highs on the VIX. So again, I'm starting off with the VIX because this is more or less a leading indicator that I use. It's an oscillating index. It's also known as the fear index. And it's something that I believe every investor and trader should keep on their watch list. Now, moving right along, because the S&P, for the most part, is inversely related to the VIX, I drew these forecast lines. Again, last Friday, I said we would go up to fill this gap. It was a very slight gap, but that's exactly what happened. And in the process of filling the gap from last week, we actually gapped up. You see, on Wednesday, we gapped up. On Thursday, there you go. There's another long shadow above that candle, and then we came lower again. Now, I am not going to move this forecast line. In fact, I'm keeping it right in place, right there. The end of the line is bringing us to 432.57, and the timeline on that is roughly February 17th. Now, often I've said that it's the price target that's most important, and the time on that timestamp there in that little data box is secondary. All right, so notice what's happening. We close right back below the 20-period moving average on higher volume, and in the process, we are seeing a cross in the stochastics, and this is very important right here. We see a cross below the momentum line, that zero line on the CCI. Usually when we get that cross below or above, the trend continues for about 2 to 4 days in the direction of the cross. And again, being that this is a cross below, I'm expecting lower prices on the SPY for the CCI. So I'm not going to draw my forecast lines on the CCI. I think enough is being said here in the forecast for the price. So we will leave it at that. Now, if we look at the diamonds, it's going to look a little bit differently. And of course, it's only 30 stocks that are being tracked. We came very close to my downside price target. Again, look at the date. That's February 11th. Not as important as the target. I still think we're going to hit that target just like that. So I'm going to draw a horizontal line all for next week. I think we could see that target hit, and then we'll have to keep an eye on whether or not we get a drop in volume for a possible short-term bounce. I'm not going to go that far ahead, but we can see down below, again, the CCI has crossed below that zero line, that momentum line. And if you recall, last week, I said we would most likely see the CCI cross below the momentum line. Again, go back in the description box and click on the link from last week's report so you can go and review my comments. It's a great way to learn the charts when you put yourself back at that time when we didn't have any of this price action, and then more or less rehearse the signals as I call them out. Obviously, this is not rocket science, but it's basically following the money, following the trends, the long-term trends, short-term trends, and that's really important. Now, one other thing I want to point out before I get on to the Qs is this. This is a chart where I've overlaid the moving averages that I track most often. Now, I don't always keep these lines on the chart because it tends to clutter up the chart and the price action. But this blue line is the one that I keep almost always on the chart, and that's the 20-period moving average. You see, now, if you look a little bit more closely, you see that that 20-period moving average right there crossed down below that darker charcoal colored line, and that is the 200-period moving average. So let me zoom in there. You can see that cross. See that? That's a significant event because not only did the moving average cross below the 200, but the price has closed below the 200 as well. Now, again, look down below. You see the oscillators hinging lower and crossing. You got the CCI again, as we mentioned, moving lower. So again, all that momentum is pushing us lower. Now, I'm going to stay on this particular chart as we look at the Qs, right? Because the same thing is happening, but the Qs are much more dramatic in the way these moving averages are crossing. You see, the first cross came about when the 20-period moving average crossed below the 50. Then the 20-period moving average crossed below the 100. After that, the 20-period moving average crossed below the 200. And as a result of these crosses here, the 50 is now crossing below the 100. So what do we have? Well, not only do we have a shift in the momentum followed by, again, these oscillators, look down below, crossing on the stochastics, cross on the momentum on the CCI down below. You have high volume on the way down, although that's not super high volume. I'm keeping that target in place right there on the Qs. I still think we're going to hit it possibly on Monday, and then we'll have to see whether or not we get a bounce. Again, to reiterate my target from last week, that is 343.30. Came very close, but not quite there yet. And I will even go so far to say that we do have a possibility, depending on what happens between Russia, the Ukraine, and all the tension that's building up around the world, we could see a test of this support level right here. So keep your eyes on that. Remember, I promote risk management to the fullest. If you are nervous about this market, then chances are you do not have a good risk management plan in place. And again, I would strongly encourage you at least use stops, or for you option traders out there, learn how to collar your positions and protect your cash, especially on the way down. All right, I'll get a little bit more into that in a moment. All right, so now I'm going to go back to my regular charts with just my 20-period moving average right there. And again, you can see my forecast lines are in place just like they were on the moving average chart. And I want to talk a little bit about IWM. This is the small cap ETF. For months and months, I was talking about the 210 level being the level to watch out for. And that level obviously was broken in here in January and is now turned into resistance. I do believe that the 210 level will hold as resistance. As we saw yesterday, we moved up to it, came right back down. And as I zoom into this chart, you can see that we had a bearish engulfing candle right there. See that? As I magnify it, that's a bearish engulfing candle where we have a longer red body candle engulfing the previous green body. And in addition to that, we have a long shadow known as a shooting star from yesterday. All right, we have a almost cross there on the stochastics. We have a sell signal on the CCI. See that right there? When the line crosses below that red line or the plus 100 line, that is a sell signal. So while we did not hit my target from this week, and some people are calling me out on that, I am keeping that target in place at 189.06, and next week we'll have to see whether or not that support level holds. Now, if it does not hold, let's talk a little bit about that because risk management, again, being most important. If it does not hold that level right around 190, where is the next support level for IWM? Well, I brought this out last week when I expanded back and looked at the weekly charts. There's still a gap all the way down here, right around 160 for IWM. So if we break out below that key support level, we're going to see a little bit of a zigzag pattern known as the roll reversal, where support here will revert and move back to resistance here. This is known as an ABCD pattern. From A All right, a high here to B. Then we see a little bit of a bounce to C, and then C to a new low here, D, and then possibly a bounce. Again, risk management is critical in this market. I cannot overemphasize that. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I pointed out the 52-week high, 52-week low list. It's a link on the WallStreetJournal.com page. I will post this as a link in the description box below this video, but I want to point this out to you because if we look at the NASDAQ right here, see, we had 55 new highs, 52-week highs, that is, today, but look what's happening down below. We had 365 new 52-week lows. That is a 6-to-1 ratio. And in my 40 years, I've never seen such a long stretch in 52-week lows versus 52-week highs on that type of a ratio. Sometimes you'll see 1-to-1.5, 1-to-maybe-2 to the downside. We're seeing a ratio of 6-to-1 to the downside. And on the New York Stock Exchange, right here, as I flip that, you'll see we had 67 new 52-week highs versus, get this, 375 new 52-week lows. So that's a 5-to-1 on the New York Stock Exchange. So everything that we're seeing in this table more or less confirms what we are seeing in the charts, especially what I pointed out in the Qs. The markets are still pretty tech heavy. And if you look at this 20 period moving average, again, this is a weekly chart, we've got this rolling over going on. See that? And if you look at the title of last week's market report, I said we are in the transition and we are continuing to roll over. And if you remember, following my reports on January 28th, I called an official end to the bull market. We are not able to label this a bear market as such because we still need 2 quarters of data to confirm that. But I will say not only are we seeing the end of the bull market, but we are seeing the very beginning of the bear market. And if you know how to make money on the way down, this is going to be very exciting. If you don't know how to make money on the way down, I would suggest you plug into Market Rebellion. Just go to marketrebellion.com. Look for me there. I do plenty of webinars. I put out trade alerts. I talk about risk management. And every Friday, we have what's called a cocktail hour. It's a virtual session where our team of analysts get together and analyze the markets. And we just had one, and it was very exciting. We had some good discussion about what's happening around the world and how that might affect the markets, anything from, you know, Ukraine to the convoy in Canada and supply chain issues and inflation, you name it. It's looking pretty negative. But again, I've never been more excited in my career because we're not going to miss this bear market. We're going to do very well on the way down. You just have to know how to do that. All right, folks, so have a great weekend and we'll talk to you soon. So long.